USS Doris Miller, CVN 81, the fourth Ford-class aircraft carrier, has reached its first important milestone. The first cut of steel ceremony was held in Newport News with six members of Messman Second Class Doris Miller in attendance. Viewers may note that Miller, the ship's namesake, became the first African American to receive the Navy Cross for his actions during the attack on Pearl Harbor on December 7, 1941. He was on board USS West Virginia when he heard the alarm sound, promptly manned a 50 caliber machine gun despite having no formal training of the weapon, and began to fire at the attacking Japanese aircraft. While it's expected to take more than 10 years for the supercarrier to be commissioned into the US Navy, there's a lot to look forward to. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why USS Doris Miller supercarrier will be unparalleled when it comes to power projection. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play online military-themed strategy game, Conflict of Nations, which is played by millions of players worldwide. We talk a lot about military power and tactical plans of different nations on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? Conflict of Nations is set in the late 20th and early 21st century, fielding present-day and highly modern battlefield technology. At the core of the game is an exciting real-time combat system, placing players in control of an existing nation of this world and its army, pitting them against other gamers in a struggle for world domination. Units are moved across the map in real time, often taking hours to fulfill their assigned mission goals, allowing for a very deep level of strategic planning and integrated tactical execution. Forming lasting alliances or short-lived coalitions is an essential part of the modern military environment. Hence, Conflict of Nations allows players to form cooperative plans and teams in an all-out effort to conquer set objectives through the combined force of arms. Conflict of Nations can be played in PC or mobile. So why wait? Register yourself using the link in the description below and get 13,000 gold reward along with 1 month Security Council membership. Ford Class was designed to substitute technology for manpower in several kinds of activities. USS Doris Miller will see extensive automation. This will help to reduce the future operating cost. For example, the warship will have about 20% lesser crew when compared to Nimitz-class warships. Considering the 50 years lifespan of the carrier, this will translate to billions of dollars in savings. This will also mean that there will be a lesser chance of any issue or accidents due to human errors. USS Doris Miller will be much more nimble and efficient. For example, moving ordnance within the carrier has been optimized with automation. To achieve this, the ship will be built completely using digital drawings and procedures rather than traditional paperwork packages and products. One of the most important metrics when it comes to a carrier is sortie rate, how many sorties, i.e. flights, the carrier can generate each day. The US Navy's goal is to achieve a 33% increase in sortie generation, 160 sorties per day under normal conditions, 270 during wartime burst. USS Doris Miller will feature a newly designed deck. It has three aircraft elevators that are more efficient when compared to four in Nimitz-class supercarriers. Reduction in one aircraft elevator has freed up space, which will enable faster maneuvering of aircraft in the deck. With this, space for flight deck operations and aircraft maintenance is increased. There are several other smaller but consequential enhancements. This will boost the mission handling capacity in a big way. The heart of any aircraft carrier is the nuclear reactors, which provide the required power. USS Doris Miller will have newly designed reactors. Two Bechtel 1AB nuclear reactors will be installed on USS Doris Miller. Each one of these is capable of producing 300 megawatts of electricity, triple the 100 megawatts of each Nimitz-class vessel. The huge power supply provides the setup required for future expansions, like inducting lasers. The US military has been working on laser for some time now, and by the time USS Doris Miller is ready for weapons installation, powerful lasers will be available. USS Doris Miller will be equipped with the most potent radar to ever be fitted in a warship, the ANSPY 6. In general, ships have different radars for different purposes, one for scanning large areas and another for target engagement. But this is not the case with ANSPY 6, which is also known as AMDR, Air and Missile Defense Radar. ANSPY 6 consists of two primary radars and a radar suite controller, or RSC, to coordinate the sensors. An S-band radar is to provide volume search, tracking, ballistic missile defense discrimination, and missile communications, while the X-band radar is to provide horizon search, precision tracking, missile communication, and terminal illumination of targets. The S-band and X-band sensors will also share functionality, including radar navigation, periscope detection, as well as missile guidance and communication. The radar is 30 times more sensitive and can simultaneously handle over 300 times the targets of the existing ANSPY 1D 5 in order to counter large and complex raids. Although it was not an initial requirement, the AMDR may be capable of performing electronic attacks using its AESA antenna, like the APG-77 used on the F-22 Raptor, and the APG-81 and APG-79 used on the F-35 Lightning II and FA-18 Super Hornet EA-18G Growler, respectively. USS Doris Miller will use the Electromagnetic Aircraft Launch System, or EMALS. The system uses a linear induction motor with an electric current to generate a magnetic field. That field then propels a carriage down a track. Since the power delivery is linear, it negates the deficiencies of a steam catapult and is more suitable for future aircraft and drones like MQ-25 Stingray. Four of these EMALS will be present. Two will be at the bow, while the other two will be at portside, enabling the simultaneous launch of four aircrafts. USS Doris Miller will be fitted with Advanced Arresting Gear, AAG. AAG is capable of working with all current and projected future carrier-based aircraft, from the lightest unmanned aerial vehicles to the heaviest manned fighters. It's not hard to imagine what kind of destruction the air wing can do with the increased sortie rate. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.